महोदय, आज एक बहुत ही सामाजिक स्तर पर, राष्ट्रीय स्तर पर एक विशेष मुद्दे पर महोदया ने आपके माध्यम से पूरे सदन का ध्यान आकृष्ट किया। सर्वप्रथम तो उनकी इस चिंता को व्यक्त करने पे और इस चिंता के संदर्भ में एक सकारात्मक दृष्टि से सरकार के माध्यम से सभी राजनीतिक दलों के समन्वय से पूरे राष्ट्र का ध्यान आकर्षित करने के लिए आज मैं सर्वप्रथम उनको आभार व्यक्त करना चाहती हूँ। ये सत्य है कि कुपोषण की चुनौती एक सामाजिक चुनौती बनकर रह गई थी। स्वास्थ्य की दृष्टि से ये चुनौती राष्ट्रीय स्तर पर, प्रशासनिक स्तर पर शायद एक जन आंदोलन के रूप में तब उभर कर आई जब माननीय प्रधानमंत्री जी ने पोषण अभियान के अंतर्गत विशेष इस विषय पर महिला और बच्चों के कुपोषण की दृष्टि से एक राष्ट्रीय अभियान की साल 2017 में शुरुआत की। महोदय, आपके माध्यम से
माननीय मंत्री जी अब ये स्टेटमेंट लेकर दें तो उसके बारे में स्टेटमेंट अभी सिर्फ पढ़ना।
मैं स्टेटमेंट को आपके माध्यम से ले करना चाहूंगी अगर आप अनुमति
पढ़ दें उसको, जो प्रक्रिया है उसके तहत आप पढ़ दें।
आई राइज टू रिस्पॉन्ड टू द हाउस ऑन द कॉलिंग अटेंशन नोटिस टेबल बाय मेंबर्स ऑफ पार्लियामेंट श्रीमती कहकशा परवीन, श्रीमती जया बच्चन एंड श्रीमती विजिला सत्यनाथन ऑन द इशूज रिलेटेड टू मैलनरिशमेंट अमंगस्ट वुमेन एंड चिल्ड्रन विद पर्टिकुलर रेफरेंस टू पोषण अभियान। एट द ऑनसेट आई टेक दिस अपॉर्चुनिटी सर टू इन्फॉर्म द हाउस थ्रू यू that it is a known fact that undernutrition is an outcome of not one but multiple detrimental factors. These factors play their role in helping sustain this continuous burden of undernutrition, leading to our inability to achieve our desired human resource potential generation after generation. In order to achieve desired target and play the role as a global superpower, we need to focus on eradication of malnutrition so as to ensure that the coming generations are healthy, enabling higher intellectual potential, leading to enhanced work productivity. Honorable members may be aware that in spite of a number of nutrition-related programs and schemes implemented earlier by governments, India still faces the problem of undernutrition of 35.7%, stunting of 38.4% and wasting of 21% as per the National Family Health Survey for data. Therefore, on the 8th of March 2018, Honorable Prime Minister, 2017, I beg your pardon, Honorable Prime Minister launched the Poshan Abhiyan, the Prime Minister's overarching scheme for holistic nourishment.
माननीय मंत्री जी, जो जो डिस्ट्रीब्यूट हुआ है वही पढ़ना है।
आई एम रीडिंग सर। देयरफॉर ऑन द 8th ऑफ मार्च
2018 सो व्हाट हैपेंस इट विल नॉट हेल्प अस।
आई हैव जस्ट रेड दिस पर्टिकुलर स्टेटमेंट। आई एम अनअवेयर वेदर यू हैव अ डिफरेंट स्टेटमेंट।
आई हैव अ स्टेटमेंट इन माय हैंड।
इट इज अ डिफरेंट थिंग। ऑल द डाटा
The status of malnutrition in the country amongst women, children and adolescent girls is covered under the National Family Health Survey NFHS conducted periodically by the Ministry of Health and Family Welfare. Details, sir, as are in the statement that are given. To address the issues of malnutrition, Ministry of Women and Child Development is implementing the following scheme. The government has set up Poshan, Prime Minister's overarching scheme for holistic nourishment, earlier known as the National Nutrition Mission Abhiyan, on the 18th of December 2017 for a three-year time frame commencing from 2017-18 with an overall budget of rupees 9046 crore. To ensure a holistic approach, all 36 states, union territories and districts have been covered. The goals of Poshan Abhiyan are to achieve improvement in nutritional status of children from 0 to 6 years, adolescent girls, pregnant women and lactating mothers in a time-bound manner, during the 3 years with fixed targets as under. So if you allow, the tabulation is available on the floor of the House. The Abhiyan aims to reduce malnutrition in the country in a phased manner through a life cycle approach. By adopting a synergized and result-oriented approach, the Abhiyan will ensure mechanisms for timely service delivery and a robust monitoring as well as intervention infrastructure. Target is to bring down stunting of children in the age group of 0 to 6 years from 38.4% to 25% by the year 2022. The major works undertaken under this Abhiyan are ensuring convergence with other programs, information technology-enabled common application software for strengthening service delivery and interventions, community mobilization and awareness advocacy leading to Jan Andolan to educate people on nutritional aspects, capacity building of frontline functionary, incentivizing states, union territories for achieving goals, etc. Anganwadi services, which aim to improve the nutritional and health status of children in the age group of 0 to 6 years, pregnant women and lactating mothers, and reduce the incidence of mortality, morbidity and malnutrition. Under the scheme, a package of 6 services is provided through a network of Anganwadi centres, which include supplementary nutrition, preschool non-formal education, nutrition and health education, immunisation, health checkup, and referral services. Scheme for adolescent girls is implemented for out-of-school adolescent girls in the age group of 11 to 14 years for self-development and empowerment of adolescent girls, improvement of nutritional and health status, to promote awareness about health, hygiene and nutrition, support out-of-school adolescent girls to successfully transition back to formal schooling or bridge learning skill training, upgrade their home-based skills and life skills. Pradhan Mantri Matru Vandana Yojana is a centrally sponsored conditional maternity benefit scheme of the ministry for pregnant and lactating women. Under the scheme, cash incentives are provided partly compensating for their wage loss, subject to fulfillment of health and nutrition conditions. Besides, Food and Nutrition Board of the Ministry of Women and Child Development, with its 43 field units in India, is engaged in creating awareness about nutrition in collaboration with state governments, institutions through exhibitions, advertisement in audiovisual and print media, lectures promoting the consumption of balanced diets, and inclusion of fruits and vegetables in daily diets, in addition to demonstrations of low-cost nutritious recipes using locally available foods, training of field functionaries, and training in fruit preservation for grassroots level workers, celebration of nutrition-related events, etc. Ministry of Health and Family Welfare also addresses the issue of undernutrition through various interventions like promotion of appropriate infant and young child feeding practices, nutrition rehabilitation centers, vitamin A supplementation, village health and nutrition days, and mother and child protection card, anemia Mukt Bharat strategy, home-based newborn care and home-based care for young child programs, National Deworming Day, promotion for intake of iodized salt, Rashtriya Bal Swastha Karyakram and Rashtriya Kishore Swastha Karyakram and food fortification. All these schemes address one or other aspects related to nutrition and have the potential to improve nutritional outcomes in the country. As a result of these concerted efforts, the level of malnutrition has reduced in the country, as is evident from the recent report of the National Family Health Survey for 2015-16. My apologies, sir, for reading the wrong paper, and my grateful thanks to the members who corrected me. Thank you, sir.
Dhanyavaad.